So students, now we will do the next topic. As you can see here, as we have finished the steps involved in setting a business. So when a business is being started, when a business is being executed, when a business carries all the activities and operations, so it has to move through different phases of a business cycle, which consist of five steps. And these business five steps are namely, firstly the expansion stage, secondly the peak stage, third is the recession stage, fourth is the trough stage, and fifth one is the recovery stage. So all the business organization, every organization has to move through these business cycles, because business comes with a part that is risk. So business risk is an inseparable and inherent part, and this all the business organization all around the globe has to move through all these five cycles, which are namely expansion. When a business tries to operate its activities, when a business produces the goods and services, so when the business kicks off, when the business starts producing and sells the goods and services, so when the business sells the goods and services, so it gets off to a good momentum, the products and services are being sold and the cash inflows, sales are happening, profits are happening, so the business tries to get to a start. Means the business from the point of origin, as you can see in the board, I have already drawn a pictorial representation of the five phases of the cycle of business, where from the origin of the business tries to start. So from this point, this is the point of origin where the business kicks off. Means the business starts, and business starts to rise and rise. So this happens when the business produces the goods and services with all its resources, such as physical, financial, managerial and other resources, manpower, money, material, method, etc. The business combine all these resources, integrate all these resources to transform into a finished product and services, and then sell it to the public, so the public can use these products and services for satisfying the utility, and in return the company gets the money. And when the company gets a good reputation, gets a good image, and gets getting regular customers, and cash inflows are there, sales are happening, and the revenue is generating, and the profits are happening, so the business from here starts and gain the speed, gain the momentum. And then when the sales are high, when the incomes are high, the purchase is being done, so all this when it is on a high mode, so the business reaches the top or pinnacle or zenith mode. Means it reaches the top, which is known as recovery. When the products are being sold at a high, very speed rate, the product is being sold and the cash inflow, sales and profits are being made by the business. So the business, when from expanding stage, it reaches the peak, means it reaches the boom or the topmost cycle. So the company start producing more and more goods and services in anticipation of demand from the public. But in case when the demand of that product and services gradually declines, means there is not a single product that always has a constant demand, it gradually changes its demand and supply. But in the third stage, when the company is in a producing mode, when a company goes on producing the goods and services in that stage, but the sales comes down, the producer or the manufacturer keeps producing the goods and services, but ultimately the sales plummet down, the sales comes down crashing, and then the producer realizes that the demand of goods and services has plummeted down, has fallen down, and the sales of goods and services has come down, but the production is still high. So then in that recession stage, the cash inflows decreases to a very big extent, and the profits are being also very much reduced, sales have been reduced. So the company enters into a recession mode, that is the downfall. This expansion and peak, this represent the prosperity stage, when that is in the high, and when the business cycle goes into a low or declining phase, that is known as trough. And when the business cycle goes further deep down, here means the extreme peak, extreme points of the business cycles are known as peak and trough. So the extreme points, that is known as boom or peak, and the extreme low point is known as trough. So when the sales plummet down because there is a huge gap between the demand and supply, there is less demand of the goods and services and there is more supply, so there is a big gap. As the gap cannot be bridged, so the business continuously goes on falling and reaches into the trough stage, where it goes that it cannot cope up with the expenditure. The cost of the goods and services is high and the sale is very low. So it reaches into the trough stage or depression stage. And in the last stage, that is recovery. Every business can recover from the bottom brink, but they need to implement and they need to change some ideas, change some technology, change some material, machineries and manpower. So whenever a company changes from their outdated, obsolete ideas and other forms of machinery outdated, they need to stick to the new, which is in demand right now, means the sophisticated machinery, the skilled manpower and the premium quality goods and services at reasonable price. So when the company changes their stance, when the company shifts from outdated or obsolete idea to a new idea, bringing some unique relativity and uniqueness, some innovations and some new to products and services which the consumer wants it, so the sales wants or the sales kicks off. So as you can see, there was expansion, then it hit the boom at the very peak or zenith. Then when the company sales decline, the profits and sales decline, the company went into a mode of recession and trough. And when the company thought that it need to have a changeover of the materials, the machinery, the other resources such as your idea, they want to come with some new innovations and creativity, and those ideas which they have launched, they met with the aspirations of the people, taste and preferences of the people and the consumers, again they purchased the goods and services of the company, then the sales of the goods and services started taking off, it gained the momentum, and then the company slowly started to take off, because the goods and services were being sold off, again the cash inflows were coming and again the profit were being maximized. So this is the part and parcel of business. Each business has to go through these stages. No business concern is very much sure and accurate that it will remain forever at the peak period. There are several businesses, namely like Tata Group of Companies, Reliance Industries Limited, they were on a peak high, they were on their high, but there were times when they came down. So these are the five stages. Expansion is the first stage where the company gains the momentum and peak is the second stage where the company reaches the top of the company cycle, where they reaches the pinnacle of the or the zenith, and then when the company's sales fall, when the company's incomes and cash inflows and profit falls, it moves to the recession. Then again the company's sales fall to very low minimal, the profit falls, it moves to the trough or the recession or depression stage. And when the company initiates some new ideas, innovation, creativity of new products and services to match the demands and preferences of people, comes with new sophisticated machinery, quality goods and services, so it again takes off the sales and the profit comes in. So the extreme points of this cycle are known as peak and trough, and this is the pictorial or diagrammatic representation of the five phases of the cycle of business. So all of you do listen to the audio clips and watch the video very carefully, attentively, several times, so as to grab the meaning and content and concept of it, so as to get the conceptual clarity of it. And watch the video several times, and if you do have the book, do refer to the book so as to get the insight and meaning of it. And if any sorts of doubt arises, do revert back to me so I can give back you all the necessary assistance as soon as possible. And one more thing, that you have to complete your homework assignment task, that is chapter 1 business environment and chapter 2 entrepreneurship. We have done all the things, we have completed all the details, all the things, all the explanation we have done in detail. So your homework assignment task is to study thoroughly chapter 1 and 2 several times and finish all your updation of the copy regarding the chapter 1 short and long question answers and chapter 2 short and long question answers. So these copy will be assessed, these copy will be evaluated and checked, and on the basis of the updation of your classwork copies, how much work you have done, the marks will be allotted. So these things have to be dealt with very seriously. All the students must take it severely and seriously, because if you not do, then there will be a very not good consequences. So all of you have to complete your chapter 1 and chapter 2 short and long question answers, and do watch the video very carefully, all the videos of chapter 1 and 2, and if any sorts of doubt arises, do revert back to me so I can provide you the required assistance.